See one more chemical equation here. Now on the reactant side, we have C3H8 and combining with oxygen. Here we have on the product side, we have CO2 and H2O. Now balance this chemical equation. Now write down the number of atoms on the reactant side and product side. Okay. Now here we have the atoms as on the reactant side, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Yes, same on the product side also, carbon, oxygen and hydrogen. Now see, on the reactant side we have carbon atoms are 3. Yes, now on the product side we have 1. Yes, now hydrogens here 8, here we have 2. Okay, oxygens reactant side 2, product side we have, here we have 2 and here we have 1, total 3. Yes, now on the reactant side we have 3 carbon atoms, on the product side we have only 1 carbon atom. First we have to balance these carbons. So here we have less number, so I want to take here the number as 3. So here we have 3 molecules of CO2. Now we are not changing any number on the reactant side, so I am writing the numbers as like this only. So here we are changed. So here the it is increased 1, 2, 3. Now hydrogen atoms are not changed, so it is remains as 2 only. Now come to oxygens. Here we have 3 to the 6 and here one more 7. Okay, now see, now carbons are balanced. Come to hydrogens. On the reactant side we have 8 hydrogens, on the product side we have only 2 hydrogens. So here we have to balance this. So now I want to take 4 before the H2O. Now it is 4 to the 8. So write down here, we are not changing on the reactant side any number. Okay, now here we have 3 carbons and 4 to the 8, 8 hydrogens, and now oxygens also increase it. Here we have 6 and here we have 4, total 10. Yes, now see, the last one is the oxygen here. Yes, on the reactant side we have 2 oxygen atoms, but on the product side we have 10 oxygen atoms. So where we have to balance now? On the reactant side. Okay, now see, here we have only 2 oxygen atoms. Yes, here I want to take 5. Now it is increased to 10. We are not changing these numbers, so I am writing as it is. Now it is changed into 10. Yes, now here we are not changing any number, so these are remains same. So now see, okay, now reactants of carbon, here we have 3 and here also we have 3. Yes, hydrogens on the reactant side we have 8, product side also we have 8. Oxygens, here we have 10 and here also we have 10. Yes, is this chemical equation is balanced? Yes, it is balanced now. See one more chemical equation. Here I have taken HCl and K2Cr2O7 as the reactants, and product side we have KCl, CrCl3, H2O and Cl2. Yes, now write down the number of reactants and products here. So now here we have the reactants K, Cr, O, H and Cl. Okay, now product side also we have same. Yes, Now write down here number of K atoms on the reactants as 2. On the product side we have 1. Yes. Now Cr as here 2. Now here we have only 1. Oxygens on the reactant side we have 7. And product side we have only 1 oxygen atom. Okay. Now hydrogens. Here reactant side we have 1 and product side we have 2. Now last finally chlorines. Here reactant side we have 1 and product side we have, here we have 3 and one more here 4 and here 2. Total 6. Okay. Now we have to balance one by one now. Now first K means potassium here. On the reactant side we have 2. On the product side we have 1. So here we have to balance. So for that purpose I am taking 2 here. Okay. Now write down the number of atoms now. Here we are not changing any number. So I am writing as it is. Okay. Now here it is increased. So the number is 2 here. Okay. Now chromium Cr, that is not changed, that is remains as 1 only. Oxygens is also not changed. Hydrogens also not changed. Chlorines are changed now. Here we have 2 and here we have 3. So total 5 and here 2. So total 7. Yes. Now come to Cr means chromium. On the reactant side we have 2. On the product side we have 1. So here we have to balance. So here I want to take 2. Okay. Now here again we are not changing anything on the reactant side. I am writing as it is. Now on the product side, now see here we are not changing anything. So K potassium is number 2 only. Now Cr. So it is changed now. So it is 2 now. Oxygens is not changed, so this is 1 only. Hydrogens also not changed, it is 2 only. Now chlorines, here we have 2, here we have 2, 3 is a 6. So 2 plus 6 8 plus 2, total 10. Yes. Now come to oxygens. Reactant side we have 7, on the product side we have only 1. So there we have to change the number. Here I want to take 7. Okay. Now on the reactant side we are not changing anything. So the numbers remain same. Okay. Now come to product side. K means potassium is same. That is 2. Cr means chromium, that is also 2. Oxygens, it is increased. So 7 ones are 7. Now hydrogens, 7 2s are 14. So it is changed now, 14. Finally chlorines, we are not changing anything. So this is remains as 10 only. Okay. Now the next one is the hydrogens. So see here, on the reactant side we have 1 hydrogen atom. On the product side we have 14 hydrogen atoms. So on the reactant side we have the less number. So here we have to balance now. So for that purpose, here I want to take number as 14 here before the HCl molecule. So now it is changed. So we are not changing the potassium number as well as chromium and oxygen. These are remain same here. Now it is number changed from 1 to 14 as well as chlorine also. It is also changed 1 to 14. So okay, now come to this product side, we are not changing anything. So these are remains same. Now hydrogens also balanced. Now finally we have chlorine. So see, on the reactant side we have 14 chlorine atoms. On the product side we have 10 chlorine atoms. Yes. Now there we have to change the number. Okay. Now see here. Now let's count the number of chlorine atoms there. So here we have 2 and here we have 2, 3 is a 6. Okay, total 8. Okay, so here we have 2, 2 is a 4. Okay, sorry. Here we have to take the number as 3 here. So now count the total number of chlorine atoms here. Here we have 2 and 2, 3 is a 6. Okay, here we have 6. Total 8. Now here we have 6. 3, 2 is a 6. Now total number of chlorine atoms here 14. Now write down here. We are not changing any number here, so I am writing as it is. No, the potassium is remains same, and chromium, this is also same, oxygen, this is also same, hydrogen, this is also same. Now chlorine atoms are increased from 10 to 14. Okay. Now once check all the atoms in this, here we have potassium are 2 on the reactant side, product side also we have 2. Chromium atoms here we have 2 and here also 2. Oxygen atoms here we have 7 and here also 7. Hydrogens here we have 14 and product side also we have 14. Finally chlorines on the reactant side we have 14. And product side also we have 14 chlorine atoms. So all the atoms in this chemical equation are balanced. So this is the way to balance the chemical equation.